Hello everyone. Today we will discuss about the financial management. What do you mean by the financial management? Scope of the financial management, objective of the financial management, and various financial decisions in business. So first, what do you understand by financial management? Financial management deals with procurement of funds and their effective utilization in business. So first aspect is procurement of funds. Procurement of funds means funds can be obtained from different sources, example equity, preference capital, debentures, and funds procured from different sources have a different characteristics in terms of risk, cost and control. The procurement of funds involves the following steps. One is identification of sources of finance. Second is determination of finance mix. And third is raising of funds. And fourth is division of profits, mean dividend decision. And second aspects of the financial management is effective utilization of funds. The finance manager is responsible not only for procurement of funds, but also for its effective utilizations. He analyzes the financial implications of each decision. Second question is, what are the objectives of financial management? First objective is profit maximization, and second objective is wealth maximization. Profit maximization means the finance manager has to make his decision in a manner so that the profits of the business are maximized. Profit maximization as an objective has the following advantages. First advantage is it is must for survival of business. Second, it is essential for growth and development of business. Third, profit making firms only can pursue social obligation. In other side, profit maximization have some disadvantages. Profit maximization as an objective is too narrow because profit maximization ignores the time pattern of return and it also ignores the risk factor. But in wealth maximization objective of a firm should be to maximize its value or wealth. Wealth or value of the firm is represented by the market price of its common stock. This value is a function of two factors. First is earning per share and second is capitalization rate. So we can calculate the value of firm by formula earning per share divided by the capitalization rate. The concept of wealth in the context of wealth maximization objective refers to the shareholders' wealth as reflected by the price of their shares in the share market. Wealth maximization means maximization of the market price of the equity shares of the company. This maximization of the price of the ordinary shares of the company should be in the long run. The long run implies a period which is long enough to reflect the normal market price of the shares irrespective of short-term fluctuations. The long run price of the ordinary shares reflects the considered appraisal of the investors regarding the overall performance of the company and its growth prospects. In fact, such a price of the equity shares is an index of the company management. By following policies which increase the earning per share in the long run and which reduce the overall risk classes in which the investors place the company. The wealth maximizing objective means maximizing the net present value is equal to wealth of the owner. The net wealth of the owner is the difference between the present value of its benefits and the present value of its cost. Any action that has a positive net present value creates wealth for the owner. Third, define the scope of financial management. The scope of the financial management is to secure the capital needed by the enterprise and employ it in the production and marketing activities in such a way that it can generate the sufficient return on invested capital with an intention to maximize the wealth of the owner. Fourth question is, what are the basic financial decision or function of the financial manager? Finance function or decision can be divided into two parts. One is long-term financial decision, second is short-term financial decision. In long-term financial decision, have a three decision. One is long-term asset mix, we can say capital vesting decision. Second is capital mix, we can say capital structure decision. And third is profit allocation, we can say dividend decision. In investment decision, finance manager analyze every investment decision before it is made and accept only such decisions that would be compatible with the goal of value maximization. Second decision is capital structure decision. Capital structure refers to the mix of sources from where the long-term funds required in a business may be raised. In other words, we can say it refers to the proportions of debt, preference capital and equity capital. Third is dividend decisions. The finance manager assists the top management in deciding as to what amount of dividend should be paid to the shareholder and what amount should be retained in the business itself. Dividend decision depend upon numerous factors like trend of earnings, trend of share market price, requirement of funds for future growth, cash flow situations, and tax positions of shareholders. In short-term financial decisions, we can say liquidity decisions or working capital management decisions. Financial manager actual estimate of working capital requirement by determinations of each components of current assets and current liabilities, and they take the financial decision related to the working capital requirement. The finance manager has to ensure that all branches, factories, departments and units of the organizations are supplied with adequate funds to facilitate smooth flow of business operations. Thank you everyone for watching this video. Thank you very much.